Hey guys, Travis Gillespie here. We're solving equations. We're moving on to multiplication equations, so let's get started with step one, locate the variable. The variable is p, it's right here. Step two is to think, how can I isolate this variable? Well, I want to take 5 and I want to push it to the other side of the equation. Step three is the inverse operation. So how can I push this over to the other side of the equation? Or how can I get rid of it on this side of the equation? I've got to do the inverse operation. The inverse of multiplication is division. So I'm going to divide this side by 5. Step 4 is to balance the equation. So whatever I do to this side, I've got to do to the other side of the equation. So I'm going to divide by 5. Well, 5 divided by 5, that turns into 1. So pretty much I'm going to think about this as, well, I have 5 divided by 5, which is 1. And I'm going to bring that p down. So 1 times p. And I'm going to actually write this over off to the side real quick. And I want to ask myself, 1 times p, well, what is 1 times p? Well, 1 times 2 would be 2. 1 times 3, and in fact, I'm going to write that down. So 1 times 2, so 1 times 2, it's equal to 2. 1 times 3 is equal to 3, and so on. So whatever you multiply 1 by, it equals that other value. So 1 times p, well, there's no difference. It will equal p. It will equal the same value that you're multiplying it by. So rather than writing down 1 times whatever variable you're using, remember, you're going to be dealing with a lot of different multiplication equations. So rather than writing 1 times p, just leave it as p. We're going to think of this as hiding the 1. So I'm going to go ahead and just hide that 1. I'm going to erase this real quick. So I'm left with p on this side, or you can think about it as 5 and 5 cancel out, and you're left with p. Okay, so I have p is equal to, well, 75 divided by 5. If you were to calculate that, you would find out that 75 divided by 5 is 15. So now, step 5 is to check your answer. We're going to substitute 15 back into the original equation for p. So now I'm going to rewrite that original equation as 5 times 15 is equal to 75. And I've still got to check this answer. So 5 times 15, if you actually calculated that, you'd find out it is equal to 75. So 75 is equal to 75, and this checks out. So I'm going to put a check mark down. So now I'm going to rewrite the solution to the equation below. P is equal to 15, and I can box this answer. Cool, let's take a look at another problem. Going to go ahead and hide that and get another problem up on the screen. I'm going to just slide that over a little bit. Okay, so I'm going to work through this problem a little bit quicker. This would be a good time to pause the video and try practicing on your own. Remember to follow through the 5 steps. So I'm working with the multiplication equation. I'm going to divide on both sides of the equation to keep the equation balanced. Multiplication of 5 and division of 5, well, they cancel each other out. I'm left with 1. 5 divided by 5 is 1, or simply p. And p is equal to 25 divided by 5 will give me a value of 5. I'm going to substitute 5 into the original equation for p. So now I have 5 times 5 is equal to 25. Well, 5 times 5, that will give a value of 25. And that is equal to 25, which checks out. I'm going to put a check mark down. And I can rewrite the solution to the equation below, which is p is equal to 5. Now I'm just going to box that answer up. Cool, I'll see you in another video.